Thanks, guys. Thanks for coming out on a Saturday night. Look at all these shiny, happy people. All right, well, some finger style, so no flat picking and no banjos. All right. Style guitar player named Etta Baker. That was called the Knoxville Rag. She played it. She left a lot more room in it the way she played it, so I put in a lot of extra doodads. So may or may not be a good thing. Here's an old tune that used to be done by Gid Tanner and the Skillet Lickers, and their guitar player was a guy named Riley Puckett. He wasn't a fingerstyle guy, but I always liked the song, so I'll do it for you. Thank you. think I'm bragging, but don't get me wrong, 'cause I can't run for office when I'm singing this song. I'm a rambling gambler and I'm drunk every night. I'm here to tell you I'm ragged but right. Three of us out here, and I'm going first because I can't pick real fancy because that's what Nathaniel's gonna do, and I can't tell funny stories because that's what Ed's gonna do. So I'm actually not sure why I'm here. I'm just gonna get it over with, get it out of the way. Actually, the thing that brought me to the guitar is the kind of stuff that we'll be playing for you tonight. When I got interested in playing the guitar, this was, you know, the glory days of the 1970s, where, you know, if you played any kind of guitar, you were doing or, you know, like that. And I thought that was, you know, kind of cool. But the first time that I heard Mississippi John Hurt, game over for me. I realized that's where I wanted to go. And one of his tunes that it took me a long time to figure out how to play was a thing called Avalon Blues, and that's where he was from, Avalon. So I'll try to do that for you. This morning, just about 9:30. Got to New York this morning, just about 9:30. I was thinking about Avalon, could hardly keep from crying. Avalon's my hometown, always on my mind. Mine. Going back home to heaven. I got a pretty mama all the time. This is old Kalamazoo from the 30s, and this is one of the nicest finger pick guitars that I own. I have a very sentimental attachment to this guitar because my wife let me buy this just before we got married. And I realized that she did it so that I'd go through with getting married. You know, it was like a little bribe here. It's like, oh, God, why don't you go get that guitar? That'll be fine. Thanks, honey. I just did a stage play. I was a musician in a stage play down in Indianapolis back in January and February. And it was a production of To Kill a Mockingbird, and they wanted to have string music. And one of the tunes that was sort of the thread that ran throughout the entire piece was a tune picked by the musical director, this fellow named Tim Grimm, who you might know. He sometimes plays up here, called Little Birdie. And I spent so much time playing that song and having it be, you know, part of my everyday with the piece, with the theater piece, that I just started to add it into the repertoire a little bit. So here's the old tune, Little Birdie.
You fly so high, and I'm the only one.
and people see me, you know, at gigs and stuff, and they're like, oh, you look so cool with that watch. It's see, the dial is really big, and I can see the numbers without having to put my glasses on, so that's cool. This is a tune, this was recorded in 1927 in Chicago by a group of guys that call themselves the Down Home Boys. And it's one of the many versions of the old tune, Alabama Bound. Fingerstyle means you're doing all sorts of fancy stuff and it's real fast and all that sometimes. Sometimes the real beauty is in the real simple stuff. Pete Seeger was at a concert, and he was having trouble getting his banjo in tune. And he said to the audience, he says, I think he was playing Carnegie Hall or something like that. And he said, you ever wonder why you don't see classical players spending as much time tuning as the folk players do? And he said, it's because we care. That's Pete now, you take it up with him.
Singing green, green, rocky road, promenade.